Take the first step in meeting Ireland's biggest challenge and find your number on change.ie. Change your world. Change the world.
I'm asking to marry me and she goes, I can't marry you. And I went, oh. And she went, what are you joking?
Irishman goes into a library and says, fish and chips, please. And the librarian goes, this is a library. And he goes, oh, sorry, fish and chips, please.
I was wanted for a bigger part, Jennifer's sister.
Are you a real person?
How often have you been arrested now?
Well, I've been arrested 67 times.
Oh, my God!
Did you do that? Graham Norton, Friday at 9 on 3.
What's this? Brand new episodes of The Royal with some added attractions, or should that not be distractions, mate?
Welcome back to Wednesday Lunch with the Loose Women. Joining me, Jackie Brambles, today are Sherry Hewson, Carol McGiffin and Jane McDonald. Now, the toxic bachelor in Sunday's Fabulous magazine was talking about the dilemma of just who should pick up the bill on those all-important first few dates. He comes to the conclusion... You all right, love?
Yes, I've got to fly.
OK. He comes to the conclusion that splitting the bill after the second date is the best way to a man's heart. Is he right, though? Would you happily pay your own way, or should men always pay?
Well, you see, my thing is, I do think men should pay on the first date, because I think that's important. And I think any man worth his salt would be insulted if you started to get your money out and started to say, can I, would, could you do... And I absolutely, he's asked you out, so why would you then try and pay?
Because some women say they feel obliged.
Obliged why,
in
Carol?
Other areas.
At the end of the evening. Yeah.
No, we're talking about a first date. You don't do that on the first date. Do you?
Well, I know. Some of us don't even need the date.
Time to...
That is the date.
No. You don't have to feed cattle for that. No. I think that times have changed a little bit now, and I know, personally, I don't mind picking up the tab because I think it depends on income.
Not every time.
No, not every time, but turnabout, definitely, because it's expensive to go out and eat out and have a bottle of wine and everything else. And if you're constantly... You know, especially when they're on less than you are, I think that's a bit unfair.
But
I think it's fair to take turnabout.
Do you sort of sort it out before you go? Because this is why I prefer not to go on dates, because they're just so fraught with embarrassment and fumbling and, well, not that sort of fumbling, but, you know, fumbling, like, oh, who's going to pay? Oh, it's going to spoil your dinner if you don't know who's going to pay. Should I get my credit card out? Whatever. Yeah. So do you get it sorted out beforehand? Because if I were going to go, I'd say, right, are you taking me out for dinner or what?
Yeah.
Are you paying? Great.
Yeah.
And if not, are we going... Get it sorted out first, and then you can have a good time.
That's
do you
true.
Do?
Yeah, I actually do. Yeah.
I went out with a vicar's son.
Oh, David. Sort of a preacher man.
Yes. Yeah. And I must admit, and he used to take me nice places. Now he would have been so insulted had I tried to pay for a meal.
Did you ever try?
No.
But anyway,
he would have been because he was a gentleman, and I agree with you. You know, you decide who's got. There's no money involved. Well, then don't go for the dinner date. But the thing is, if you do, I just think somebody like, you know, David would have just died if I'd have gone for my wife. He would have thought that was so insulting that a woman in the middle of a restaurant would get some money out. What have those
That's
days
fairly
gone?
Fairly old-fashioned point of view, I
is
would
it?
Say. In this, well, in this day and age of, you know, equal rights, equal pay, allegedly.
Allegedly?
You know, I think it's fine. And I think, as you say, Jane, I think it depends on what the person's earning, you know. And, you know, you can't sort of say, I would like to be taken to this fabulous restaurant if the person's not earning that kind of money.
No,
you've got
absolutely.
To be a little bit sensitive to that. But I do have to say, you know, it is nice to be taken out to dinner and be treated to that. That feels to me more like a date than just going for something to eat with someone.
Well, then do it turnabout. That's how I say, you know.
Take turns.
Yeah.
Yeah, you've got to
right?
explain that. Yeah. Way
oh, well, I would say take turnabout.
Take turnabout.
Yeah.
You know, then you can pick the restaurant as well.
I must admit, I went out about a few weeks ago and I went out with this guy and I didn't think about it really because I do like nice wine. And he said, order any wine, whatever you like. So I ordered this wine. I didn't realise how expensive it was. And he didn't drink, really. Mm. So he said, and then, you know, you can take it home with you and I finished the whole bottle.
Awesome.
I didn't think anything about it.
Well, you should have ordered another one, saying, I'll take this one out.
I wouldn't have minded.
See, I think, I don't know, I'm too wary of dates and I don't particularly
dating.
Want all that, you know, that mystery. I'm actually considering the idea of hiring a gigolo.
Are you?
Well, no, listen, seriously.
Really?
No, seriously. Don't dismiss it.
I'm ready to listen. I'm gobsmacked, but I'm ready to listen.
There is one, you know, around town who's written a book, and he was on, I think he was on This Morning last week or something. Mm-hmm. And I was reading an article that he'd done an interview for a magazine, and I was quite intrigued. Now, I would never, ever have thought in a million years that there would have been a woman on this earth who would have had to have, yet alone volunteered, to pay for the services of a gigolo. And they are more than just, you know, going out for dinner, obviously.
So you can have a bit
the other.
Well, yeah. I mean, I've completely changed my mind after reading that.
I think that's a brilliant idea. Fantastic, absolutely. Because they're going to flatter you, aren't they? They're going to make you feel fantastic.
Yeah, but
they're
lying.
Don't clean your house.
What?
They're lying. They're being paid to say all that. And
that's
they're being
all right.
paid to.
So what?
They don't mean it.
We don't care.
Slightly tragic about having to pay for somebody to be with you in your company or behind closed doors.
No commitment.
That a bit seedy?
If that's all you want, then why not?
So you don't want a relationship. You just want wahey and a bit of a dinner.
No, I just want to know what it feels like. I want to remember that kind of experience. But I definitely don't. I don't want. No,
can you get that doll
not,
back
for, not forever. But I just think it might be quite nice. Yeah.
But there's no commitment.
At least he'll know what he's doing.
He's not going to stay around. You don't have to wash his socks or his knickers.
But why do you really like anything? Him?
What if you get attached?
Oh no, you don't do
I
that.
I won't.
No, no,
I
you
won't.
Just don't.
How, I couldn't afford to get
You've got to pay
he's
for
quite, what is wrong? We're just going out on an ordinary date, love.
Oh,
with a man who just likes you for you and doesn't have to be paid to be there.
Well, you know, if that were as easy as you say, then that probably would have happened by now, but
exactly.
It hasn't happened. And I can't really see the problem. And I know a lot of people just think that it's morally terrible, it's crass, it's
it
one of the
isn't.
Worst things. I don't think it is.
Men do it all the time.
Yeah, they do, but in a different kind of way. In, I think, a more sleazy kind of way, because they
Absolutely.
Don't actually go out with prostitutes. They just go and have sex for cash. And the gigolo doesn't. The gigolo, all you have to do is take him somewhere nice. So you get to go as well. And it comes with you.
So it's better value for money than a prostitute, then.
I think you can get rid of him.
More bang for your buck, as it were.
And then you go, well, no, you end up paying for the meal, don't you?
I know.
So
it's
but
twice
you get
as
what
much.
You want at the end of the
anyway,
day.
As I said, I'm just thinking
You're
about
You're considering it.
I'm considering it, but I'm absolutely gobsmacked that Sherry, out of all of us, also thinks it's quite a good idea.
Brilliant idea.
Okay, let's see what our first guest thinks. Our first guest today started off singing in church before taking the plunge as a professional in her mid-teens. Over the years, she's fronted a number of radio and TV shows, but later this month, she's set to return to her first love, singing, joined by a plethora of other stars. But let's remind ourselves of the single that shot her to fame.
You are my one.
Knocking around the scene together.
I haven't seen you in ages.
Do you know the first time I heard you singing was, and unless I've gone bonkers, but I'm sure this was you, it was, I think it was at the Camden Pally. Yeah. Prince was doing an after gig private
That's
show.
The one.
And you were sort of watching Prince and everything, and he suddenly started